Defense Attorney Joe Amendola began his cross-examination by questioning victim 10 about his second year at the Second Mile charity. He said, "The second year I met Jerry Sandusky in the pool again, he came up from behind me, swam between my legs, lifted me on his shoulders, and he slid his hand up my shorts. Mr. Sandusky reached his hand up the front of my shorts and grabbed a hold of my genitals. I was just trying to get off his shoulders." And victim 10 is then questioned about the next occurrence of sexual conduct. He says, "He took me to his house. In the car on the way to Sandusky's home, he had his hand on my thigh. Then Amendola asked, did he say anything when he did that? Victim number 10 answers, no. We went down in the basement. I went first, and Mr. Sandusky came down a little later after that. We started wrestling. He pinned me to the ground. He pulled my shorts down and started to perform oral sex on me." Victim 10 then talks about the next time he saw Sandusky. He says, "Later that year, he picked me up, took me shopping. We went to the Nittany Mall." He was asked, "What did he buy you?" Victim number 10 says, "Some shoes, some clothes for school. He bought me a video game. I believe we went to his house afterward." He was asked, "Did anything sexual happen?" He said, "Yes. He performed oral sex on me again." "He performed oral sex on you?" he was asked, and vice versa. Toward the end of the cross, the witness describes an incident when he and Sandusky were alone in a convertible car. He says, "He wanted me to perform oral sex on him. I said no. He got angry with me. He made a threat to me. And then he apologized shortly after for what he had said and told me that he loved me.